Everyone uses the concepts of hurt and resentment, but do we really know what we're talking about? I am Rodrigo Guim, an anthropologist and social critic, and this is Critique with Nietzsche and Foucault. What do you understand by the concept of resentment? Please comment below so I can enter into a conversation with you. If you believe thinking is fundamental in your life and you think you can debate thought, please subscribe to this channel because that is our task here. Resentment can be a mix of many types of emotions like envy, anger, sorrow, etc. Psychologist Maria Rita Kell says that it's a sorrow that is not overcome and that one does not want to forget. One resents being hurt with people, with life, they slander life, the world, they blame another for their suffering, they blame life itself for their suffering. There's always another of resentment that is to blame for suffering of oneself. Resentment lives on a lower momentary pleasure, which is the pleasure of accusing an enemy, to accuse the world, life, and other as origin or as cause of the suffering of oneself, of the resentful, is what they do. The resentful is the good, the fair, the just, the citizen of the good. That's how the resented feels itself, as being for justice, as being for the good, and always is always looking outside of itself to blame another for his own suffering. It's as if the world owes something to the resentful. The resentful idealizes the perfect world and wants the world to be corrected to the image and likeness of that ideal that the resentful carries with him. But where does this ideal come from? Where does the shaming of the world or of life come from in the resentful? First, to speak of the culture I come from Western culture, resentment is an effect of Christian morality. The morals that the resentful places as superior values, as values that level people down, that want everyone to be medium and obeying norms that are at the very best benefit the church or the state, the market, capital, and some classes of people, upper classes or medium classes. Morality creates the good citizens, which are basically citizens who are afraid of other citizens and who are also do not rise above others, may not seem strong, they must be humble. Cowardice is the order of the day in a resentful society, the society of the herd, of sameness. And the lack of courage, boldness, the lack of differences happens because this society lives on the attack on difference. Says Nietzsche, in a quote from the book Wisdom for the Day After Tomorrow. They call herd members the good. The main reason for the emergence of the good is fear. End of citation. The good subject of the herd is the coward, is the weak. The weak for Nietzsche is the one who does not act on his own will for power or will to power or vital force or force of life, but on the contrary, acts only when one is allowed, controls himself, polices himself, even without the church, the state, or before the church or the state, the market comes to normalize these people, they will police and domesticate themselves. The weak is the one who, in his way of being, of acting, of thinking, is normalized by the dominant powers that domesticate him. The resentful subject is a subject of slave morality. The subject of slave morality always needs an enemy, an other to which he first says no, only then to make his self-image of himself as a yes that is a reflected mirror of that no. If the enemy of slave morality is communist, then that means that the slave must be the communist counterpart, whatever that is, but the exact opposite of it, reactively. The subject creates himself from the image he makes of an enemy. The good subject, the resentful subject, is the one who is afraid of the enemy. But this enemy is created by the good guy himself. For the herd morality to exist, it always needs a scapegoat, a common enemy, be it evil, communism, socialism, the indigenous, the bandit, the terrorist, the intellectual, the militant, the feminist, etc. The more enemies created for the herd, the more the herd has force and the more the herd feels on the side of the good. Because so they slander all that is against the dominant culture. They go against all that they see needs to be changed, but all they see needing to be changed are those that do not want to be part of the herd. So they want everyone to be like the herd, to be normalized, to be coward, to be for the weakness, to be debased of life, to be sane, to be sameness. So the herd believes that the world is all wrong, that it needs change, etc. And it all becomes much more exciting for the herd when the herd has enemies that are to blame for everything. The herd no longer needs to look at itself. It cannot take responsibility for anything anymore because everything is somebody else's fault. It's an enemy's fault. And of course, everything that happens to be good would be then said to be coming from the herd itself. Representatives of the herd, of herd morality, as Nietzsche says, will always have enemies at the center of their action, at the center of their speech. In slave morality, resentment stands as morally superior because it feels inferior. It blames the intelligent people for itself not being so intelligent. It hates all that is elevated, such as art, science, philosophy, anything that elevates itself above the crowd. Slave morality wants to take revenge on life, on the world, on others. Nothing makes the resentful more fierce than feeling inferior because they already feel that way. Because they feel that somebody is always trying to attack them. If the resentful don't like art, science, philosophy, they say, they think it is because these work against the herd. The resentful is an egoic being steeped in its own narcissism in a way that it's very difficult to talk about art, science, philosophy, or politics with these people because they will always accuse and slander the other the moment they feel inferior, and it doesn't take a lot for them to feel this way. Resentment carries with it the constant feeling of inferiority, of blaming others or the world for this inferiority, and therefore one thinks that one has the solutions to everything. They are always very easy, like building walls or arming the population, because that's the way the resentful think. The only thing they need to do is to vindicate themselves, is to attack. Resentment is even stronger in an individualistic society like ours, in an ideology of the self, a self-sufficient, which is the dominant ideology today, liberal ideology or liberal political culture, which is the culture of the self-made man. As psychologist Maria Rita Kell puts it, individualism is an ideology that is never fulfilled because it is impossible to be only individual. We all depend on relationships, and it is those who favor us or not, those relationships, our historical relationships regarding class, gender, etc., whether they favor or not us to get there. That's what matters. And you never get to place yourself in a vacuum of history, economy, and power. Those do not exist. There's always relations that make up what we call individuals. So individuals in themselves are fictions. The resentful wants divine justice. He wants it because he wants to be chosen by God. And the confirmation of being chosen by God is if God accomplishes the righteousness that the resentful wants to see in the world. While not having divine justice, the resentful keeps poisoning himself and slandering at the world and at life, waiting for the world to be corrected and to be the image that the resentful wants it to be. The subject of slave morality, the subject of the herd, the resentful subject, wants the end of the world. But to do so, he creates a fiction about how this story will unfold. It doesn't look at its own complicity with what it criticizes. It believes in savior truths like good over evil or the revenge coming against the world after life. So it's always postponing this revenge, keeping this revenge going, but always wanting an end to suffering that is poisonous, is poisoning at the world. But this poisoning also goes back to the self. The only thing that the resentful, the slave, the herd cannot understand is themselves and their real relations with the world in which they live. They are cowards. If you are resentful, you're a coward. You point fingers and slander at the strong, at the intelligent, at those who are different because you are afraid of life. You wait for the protection of the herd against others, against life itself. You want another world that doesn't exist. You don't understand life. Because if you understood, you would cease to be herd, to be slave, to be resentful, and you would live knowing that the rewards for being heard are not worth it in the face of a life lived intensely and in its fullness and without morality, with more difference and less sameness. Resentment doesn't want anything to do with nature. Nature is the production of differences that the resentful cannot handle. They want sameness. If you are resentful, you want enemies, and you make it clear that you don't care for the world, because for you, nothing in the world is really important. I accept you as my enemy, but because you made me an enemy, together with nature, the indigenous peoples, and oppressed peoples of the world. I despise you, but I know it's not about you. It's about the systems that made you. So that's our main difference. I know where I come from, and you believe your own lies. That's it. I'm fed up. I'm out. I leave you here with a song, with a brilliant song of high Brazilian culture, everything you resentful people of Brazil hate.
A todo inimigo da fauna, da flora, aquele que promove a poluição. Aos donos do dinheiro e a quem nos devora, aos ratos e gatunos de toda a nação. A todo inimigo da fauna, da flora, aquele que promove a poluição. Aos donos do dinheiro e a quem nos devora, aos ratos e gatunos de toda a nação. Sim, vai pra toda essa gente ruim, meu desprezo será sempre assim, já não temos nenhuma ilusão. Sim, vai pra toda essa gente ruim, meu desprezo será sempre assim, já não temos nenhuma ilusão. Querendo, aos donos da verdade, pobres criaturas, aos cuias e covardes sem opinião, a todo populista traidor do povo, a todo demagogo, todo mau patrão. Sim, vai pra toda essa gente ruim, meu desprezo será sempre assim, já não temos nenhuma ilusão. Sim, vai pra toda essa gente ruim, meu desprezo será sempre assim, já não temos nenhuma ilusão. Os sete justiceiros do planeta Terra, os mesmos agiotas desse mundo cão, aos grandes predadores dessa nossa era, vetores da miséria, eu lhes digo não. Sim, vai pra toda essa gente ruim, meu desprezo será sempre assim, já não temos nenhuma ilusão. Vai pra toda essa gente ruim, meu desprezo será sempre assim, já não temos nenhuma ilusão.